Hi guys. I'm excited to see all of you soon. I know it's kind of crazy because we're going to be doing all of our learning on the computers, but we're going to do our best. We're going to read our books and we're going to listen to all the different things that I have listed out for you to do. And even though I'm not there, I'm always here for you if you need any questions. We have a little website that we can use where we can talk to each other. So we're going to try and use that as much as we need to. And I'm going to try and meet with you guys daily so we can have a bunch of kids together and you can see each other and I can see you and we can chat about all the different stuff that you guys have been doing because I miss you and I miss your faces. But before we get to that, we are going to do our very first learning activity. So last time we were in school, we were talking about nonfiction books. That was a long time ago. So if you don't remember, that's okay. That's what I'm here for, to help you out. So our nonfiction books are our books that tell us information about something we want to know. Those are our true fact books. While our fiction books are books that are not full of facts and they're full of maybe fake things, like maybe fairy tales. They're not really true. That doesn't really happen. But in our nonfiction books, what is given to us is information and it helps us learn. So the last week we were in school, we learned all about firefighters. So we read a bunch of books about firefighters. We learned what they did. We learned the tools they used. We learned when a firefighter would be called in. We learned lots about firefighters. Now, I remembered that the very last day we had, you guys had found ladybugs out on the playground and you were very excited about the ladybugs. You wanted to learn about the ladybugs and you were asking me lots of questions about ladybugs. So I thought, why not just pull a bunch of books about ladybugs this week and we're going to read about some ladybugs. Now, I can't hear you respond to my questions when I'm reading. I am going to stop and I'm going to pose some thinking questions. I'm going to think to myself, I'm going to talk through it. And if you want to talk with me, that's awesome. Okay? But I can't hear you. So I'm going to do my thinking and I just want you to think with me. All right. And then we're going to try and do a book live on another day. We're going to keep working on it because this is a learning experience for me, just as is a learning experience for you. So we're going to learn through it every day. Okay. So when I'm thinking, I want you to be thinking with me too. And if you think you have the answer, go ahead and shout it out. I think that'd be pretty cool. Now I'm going to share my screen with you. Let's see. If Miss Hayes can do it right. I've been practicing. All right, let's see. I'm going to share my screen and I'm going to show you my ladybug book. So this book is called Ladybugs and it's by Creepy Critters. Now some of you really like my creepy crawly bin and it's filled with creepy critters books. I have creepy critters books about spiders. I have creepy critters books about snakes. And those are all books that are made by creepy critters. So some of you might even recognize how this book is laid out for you because you've read our books before. Now again, this book is called Ladybugs. So if I were to say, what do I think this book is all about? Or what is this book's main idea? I wonder where we could look to find that. Oh, I'm thinking, because we just did this when we were talking about our firefighters and we were talking about the main idea. We went back to the front cover to figure out what the main idea of our story was, because the front cover usually helps us figure out what a story is all about. So this right here is our front cover. So we're talking about the main idea is, I wonder what the main idea of my story is. Well, I see a ladybug, and the title of my book is called Ladybugs. So I bet you my main idea is ladybugs. That makes sense, because when we did our nonfiction on firefighters, the name of my book was Firefighters, and the main idea on our main idea house we did later was firefighters. That makes sense. All right. Now, also on the bottom here, it says rhyme along, which means that on every page, there's going to be a set of rhyming words. We're not going to talk about the rhyming words, but I wanted to point that out to you. So in case you hear it, you can go, oh, that's a rhyming word. All right. Here's our first page. It's our table of contents. It's going to tell us what each section of the book is about. So that way later, if we wanted to come back to a certain page, we know where that page starts. So let's figure out what all of them are. So we have spots in the garden, and that starts on page 4. We have shell secrets. That starts on page 12. Ladybug lunches. That starts on page 16. I bet you that's what's going to be what ladybugs eat, because we eat at lunch. Strange babies starts on page 18. Out in the cold starts on page 20. Looking for ladybugs starts on page 22. Did you know an index are both on page 24? Okay, and when we get to the index, index is where it has all of our keywords on it. So if you're wanting to look back and find like a specific thing, there's keywords down there. You can find the page based on those keywords. We've used it a couple of times when we were reading. So just as a reminder, that's what our index is. So let's go ahead. Let's get started with our book. And it said spots in the garden was going to start on page 4. Here's page 4. So let's get started. It says, what is this creepy critter? In the garden, there are lots. They look very small and shiny and are covered in tiny spots. So I know one of our reading strategies is to look at our picture to see if we can't answer the question it's asking. What is this creepy critter? So let's look at our picture and let's see. There's 4 pictures here. I'm going to look at each one of these. I wonder what my creepy critter is. Well, let's keep reading and see if it'll tell us. If you already know, that's awesome. If you said it was a bug, you won't get any blame, but it's actually a beetle, and ladybug is its name. I tried to trick you a little bit with that one, because it says ladybug, but it's not a bug at all. It's actually a kind of beetle. That's pretty tricky of them. What color is a ladybug? Most are black and red. An Asian beetle is a type of ladybug too. They are yellow or orange instead. So, I'm trying to think, what was the color of ladybug that you guys found out in the playground? Let me think about that. What was the ladybugs that you guys found? What color were those ladybugs? Counting the spots on a ladybug won't let you know its age. Ladybugs can have different numbers of spots. That's just the way they are made. So let's count the spots on this ladybug. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This ladybug has 5 spots. Shell secrets. This is my favorite page. It says, ladybugs have a secret. They keep it under their shell. Hidden there are 2 big wings, which help them to fly really well. You see, here's our label. It says wings, and here they are. They hide underneath their 2 shells. So they have 2 shells that lay on top of their body, and their shell goes whoop, and it lifts up, and it lets their wings out. So that way they can fly around. I think that's pretty cool that they can hide their wings like that. To stay safe from birds and spiders, a ladybug can hide its head. They can also roll over on their backs and pretend that they are dead. That might help. If they see a bird swooping in, they can just pretend, oh, maybe they won't get me. Ladybug lunches. Ladybugs eat aphids. They consider them a treat. Some types of ladybugs do eat plants, but most eat only meat. Ooh, he's looking at these aphids and saying, yum. Now, some of you are thinking, what's an aphid? An aphid is another type of bug. They're very tiny. They're very, very, very tiny. So it's hard to see on the picture, but if you go onto Mayan and you want to read this book all by yourself on Mayan, because this book's on Mayan, you can look at the picture a little bit better, but these little guys are actually sitting on a leaf. They're so tiny. You can barely see them, but that ladybug's also tiny, so he can see them. They're really tiny, and then they jump around a lot. They look almost like little baby grasshoppers. Strange babies. It says, compared to their mom and dad, ladybug babies can look strange. They start out as small black larvae, and then they start to change. So this is our larva. There's our baby ladybug. And then when it grows up, it turns into that. I think that's pretty cool that it starts out looking so different, and when it grows up, it changes. Kind of like a butterfly. Out in the cold, ladybugs get together in winter, both young ladybugs and old. They find a place where they can all go to sleep when the weather starts to get cold. We talked about another animal earlier this year that does what they're doing. Oh, what's that big vocabulary word we used? I got it. Hibernate. So our ladybugs are hibernating during the winter. And if you don't remember, hibernating means that they sleep when it's cold and they wake up when it gets warm. I wonder what other animal also hibernates during the winter. That's a good one for us to mull over, and let's see if we can remember it. I'm going to keep going. I'm going to have you think about that, though. That's a good one. Ooh, we're looking for ladybugs. Can you find two ladybugs here? There's an adult and a child. Remember, the child ones look like larvae. The little long looks kind of like a caterpillar. They are hiding somewhere near these plants, just like they do in the wild. I'm going to let you look at that for just a second and see if you can't find both. One's a ladybug, and then one's that larva. Looks like, remember, looks like that little caterpillar. I'm looking. Oh, maybe that's the larva. No, that's a worm. I found the ladybug. Here's our ladybug. Because I know, because our book told us the ladybugs are red. So I was looking for red. And I found my red and black ladybug. Let's see if we can't find the larva. I mean, that's that baby or the child's one. That's a grasshopper, so that can't be it. Oh, there he is. Look at our little child ladybug. Isn't that crazy that that guy turns into that? I think that's so cool. It says, did you know a group of ladybugs is called a loveliness of ladybugs? I think that's cute. So if we ever see a bunch of ladybugs flying together, we'll call them a loveliness of ladybugs. Our very last thing on our last page is our index. So let's pick one of these things and we're going to shoot back to it. I'm just going to go to the very last one, winter. Now, I remember I was thinking, what's that other animal that does that? Let's just go back to winter and let's reread that page. So winter is on page 20. So I'm going to scroll up until I find page 20. That's page 22. Oh, there's page 20. It says, let's just reread it. Out in the cold, ladybugs get together in winter. Both young ladybugs and old. They find a place where they can all go to sleep when the weather starts to get cold. So they all get together in someplace real warm and they sleep until it gets warm outside again. And I was trying to think, oh man, what's that other animal that we talked about that also hibernated? And I remember because we read it at Christmas time, we read a book called Bear Snores On, and I remember that he was in his den sleeping and all of his friends were having a party. So does that mean that a bear also hibernates just like ladybugs hibernate? That's pretty cool because ladybugs are a beetle and bears are a mammal, yet they both do the same thing even though they look nothing alike. And that's pretty cool that they have that in common. That's how they are the same. So we're going to, I have another book about ladybugs, but I'm going to save it. We're going to read that one tomorrow. So I So what I want you guys to do now is I want you, we've done this in class, but now I'm going to ask you to help me make this because you don't have the paper in front of you. So we have to make this together. We're going to make our main idea house. So we have three things that we're going to do. Let me get my paper. So we're going to do this together. So all you need is a piece of paper. Okay. So I'm going to let you take some time and go find a piece of paper because that's all we have, a piece of paper. And you can use a pencil. Miss Hayes, remember, has to use the marker so that way you guys can see it. But all you need is a piece of paper and a marker. So I want you to go find that. And I'm going to get started and I'm going to do my first couple lines and then I'm going to hold it up for you, okay? Now, our main idea houses are just that. It's a house. All right, so I went ahead and I made my first couple of lines and I made our triangle. Remember, that's the top of our house. So I want you to go ahead and make your line up and your line down to make the top of your triangle. And then we're going to connect it on the bottom to make the rest of our triangle. And remember, the top of our house is where we're going to put our main idea. Okay, now we need to make the rest of our main idea house. But this is where it's going to be different. Because normally I make you put four key details about what you learned in our book. But today, you're only going to do two. So we're going to make the rest of our house. We're going to make a big square across the bottom. So you're going to start off with your first line. And you're just going to make it go straight down. Okay, now we're going to make another line that goes straight down from this side too. Right at the edge of your triangle. And then you're just going to connect that bottom line just to make it a full square. So remember, our house is made up of two shapes, a triangle on top, and then our completed square at the bottom. And this is where your two main details are going to go. So we're just going to cut this baby right in half. So we're going to make a line right down the middle, just like that. Okay, I'm going to number it. I'm going to put 1, 2. That way I know I want my first main idea here and my second main idea on the bottom line. So these are our key details. So we remember, oh man, where could we look to figure out what our main idea was? Oh, that's right. We need to look back at the book. So I'm going to share my screen with you one more time. And let's go back because we had already said we need to look at our title or our cover page. Our cover is always where it tells us what's going on with our story. So let's go back to our cover page or our front cover. Now our front cover tells us what our main idea is all about. So when I'm looking at my cover, I think my main idea is, what's that? We just read all about ladybugs. So our main idea is ladybugs. We have the word ladybugs already on our screen. So we don't have to try and sound that word out. We're going to use what we have in front of us. So we already know how we can spell ladybugs. Remember that ladybugs goes right up here in the attic where it says main idea. We're going to write ladybugs right in there. Okay, so I'm going to write ladybugs. I'm going to have you write ladybugs. All in the same place because our whole story was all about ladybugs. So I wrote ladybugs. You're going to write ladybugs right up in here. And then in these two spots, you're going to tell me two things you learned about ladybugs in our story. Okay, those are called our key details. Our key details are things that you've learned in the story. And since our main idea is ladybugs, I want to know two things that you've learned from our book today about ladybugs. Now, you might know lots of stuff about ladybugs, but I want you to really hone in and tell me only something that happened in the books. That way I know that you were listening to what the book was telling you. Okay? Oh, I'm going to make this. I'm going to let you guys get some time to do this. Remember, if you don't know how to spell a word, that's okay. Sound it out. Get all the sounds out that you can. Okay? Your writing does not need to be perfect, and it does not need to be absolutely correct. Does Ms. Hayes care if it's perfect? No. All I care is that you try. So do your best to write something you've learned. And if you want me to draw a picture, I'm fine with that too. So you can draw me a picture and label it, or you can try and write me a sentence, and then you can also illustrate that sentence if you'd like, because I always like looking at your pictures. But I want to make sure that you write the sentence first before you draw the picture, so that way you have lots of space for your words and you can fit your picture in the space that you have left. This was awesome. Thanks, guys, for being watching my very first lesson online, and I can't wait till I can actually live chat with you. Bye, guys. Love you.